Many different types of sampling plans exist. Why is this the case and how to handle them? My name is Marcel Swietering and I'm professor of food microbiology at Wageningen University and member of the ICMSF since 2005. We do have different types of sampling plans, since the world is not black and white, and neither microbiology is black and white. If we measure microorganisms, they can be indicators, so not per se dangerous organisms. We do have organisms that can produce toxins, but only if they are at a very high level. On the other hand, infective microorganisms might already make you ill at low levels. Also, not all humans are the same. Infants and people in hospital, specific target groups can be more vulnerable. It also depends where in the food chain we measure and what happens after the sampling point. Will the organism be inactivated or can they even increase in numbers after the sampling point? We can measure, for example, the total plate count. All aerobic organisms then will be counted, which is an indicator for the microbial levels, but not per se indicating danger. But for instance, spoilage. Also, mesophiles indicate organisms that can grow at moderate temperatures, but often are not pathogenic. Enterobacteriaceae are typical indicators of hygiene. Bacillus cereus is an organism that at higher levels can cause problems in humans. Campylobacter and Salmonella are infective organisms that even at a rather low level have a pertinent probability of infection. Poultry is, however, not eaten raw and levels are expected to go down before consumption. If the Salmonella is present in a ready-to-eat food, it's more of a risk, even more so if it would be in food for infants, like powdered infant formula. There are many different situations to assess the microbial status, so we need many types of criteria. We have qualitative and quantitative tests. In qualitative tests, we enrich a sample and determine if there is at least one cultivable cell in a sample. In a quantitative test, we really count the number of cells present. We do have two-class and three-class sampling plans, and we can use them as food safety criteria or as process hygiene criteria. When a food hygiene criterion is not complied with, appropriate management actions have to be taken, while if a food safety criterion is surpassed, a food should not be on the market. A qualitative test is testing for presence or absence, or detected, not detected. Here the amount is investigated, for example 10 gram of 25 grams, and that clearly needs to be stipulated. A quantitative test determines if the concentration is either below or above a certain level, for example 100 colony forming units per gram or CFU per gram. Then we have two-class and three-class plans. A presence-absence test is clearly a two-class because it's detected or not detected. Also, below or above 100 CFU per gram is a two-class plan. For a three-class plan, we have two limits separating the three classes, for example, which is limit 500 and 5000. We have as classes smaller than 500, between 500 and 5000, and above 5000. An example of a qualitative two-class plan is the Codex plan for Salmonella in powdered infant formula. 60 samples of 25 gram need to be tested for presence of Salmonella. An example of a quantitative two-class plan is the Codex plan for Listeria monocytogenes in food not supporting growth with 5 samples below 100 CFU per gram. These two are food safety criteria, focusing on pathogens in a ready-to-eat food. Indicator organisms may be used as process hygiene indicator and are often defined as three-class plan. An example of a quantitative three-class plan is the Codex plan for mesophiles in powdered infant formula, having as two limits separating these three classes, 500 and 5000 CFU per gram. Here both limits are quantitative. But one could also consider to have the lower level M as a qualitative and the upper level, big M, as a quantitative test, being a three-class mixed sampling plan. The lower limit M can then be not detected in 25 grams, and the upper limit N, M, 100 CFU per gram. The ICMSF spreadsheet has various steps for the different types of sampling plans. Two-class enrichment for the two-class qualitative criteria two-class counts for the two-class quantitative criteria, three-class counts for the three-class quantitative criteria, and three-class mixed for the three-class plan with a lower qualitative limit and a higher quantitative limit. Here you see the codec sampling plan for PIF. This is a quantitative two-class plan. It only has detected or not detected per sample of 25 grams, so it's a two-class and it's qualitative. The two-class enrichment is the tab to choose. Now you see the codec plan for Enterobacteriaceae in PIF. This is also a qualitative two-class plan. It only has detected or not detected per sample, so it is a two-class plan and it's qualitative. Two of the enriched samples of the 10 gram are allowed to be positive for the criterion to be complied with. Again, the two-class enrichment is the tab to choose. In the codex plan for Listeria monocytogenes in RTE foods that do not support its growth, a quantitative limit is given of 100 CFU per gram. Here the two-class count is the tab to choose. Also in the EU plan for Campylobacter in broilers, a quantitative limit is given of 1000 CFU per gram. This is a quantitative plan and it has two classes. 15 of the samples are allowed to be positive. Here again, the two-class count is the tab to choose. The number of samples allowed to be positive changed over time from originally 20 in 2018, then to 15 in 2020, and from 2025 it will go to 10. In the codex plan for mesophiles and PIF, also quantitative limits are given. This is a quantitative plan and it has three classes, below 500, between 500 and 5000, and above 5000. Two of the samples are allowed to be between 500 and 5000. Here the three-class count is the tab to choose. In a three-class mixed plan, the lower limit of the three classes M is a presence-absence test. The upper limit, big M, is a quantitative test. Here the three-class mixed tab needs to be chosen. This plan detects a high prevalence since more than one of the enrichment 10 will be positive. It also can detect a lower prevalence, high concentration, by testing whether occasional positive samples are larger than 100 CFU per gram. Sampling plans can give information for producers and for food safety authorities. This information can be targeted at safety, hygiene or spoilage, and the testing can be performed at different locations in the food chain. Since different targets are needed for these different aspects, different types of sampling plans do exist, like two-class and three-class plans, and qualitative and quantitative tests. In this manner, microbiological criteria can, together with other measures within food safety management systems, give confidence that processes are under control.